Lung volumes and capacities are fundamental concepts in respiratory physiology, serving as quantifiable measures of the amount of air associated with different phases of breathing. Lung volumes represent individual components of the breathing process, while capacities represent combinations of these volumes. We created this video to explain the difference between the two and provide a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, lung volumes refer to discrete, measurable segments of air which can be associated with a specific phase of the breathing cycle. The four primary lung volumes include tidal volume, which is the volume of air inhaled or exhaled during a normal resting breath. Inspiratory reserve volume, which is the additional volume of air that can be forcefully inhaled after a normal inhalation. Expiratory reserve volume, which is the additional volume of air that can be forcefully exhaled after a normal exhalation. And residual volume, which is the amount of air remaining in the lungs after a maximal exhalation. This volume ensures that gas exchange can continue between breaths and maintains lung elasticity. And then there are the lung capacities, which are combinations of two or more lung volumes. The primary lung capacities include inspiratory capacity, which is the total volume of air that can be inhaled after a normal exhalation. An inspiratory capacity can be calculated by adding the tidal volume to the inspiratory reserve volume. Functional residual capacity, which is the volume of air exhaled after a normal tidal volume breath in addition to the volume remaining in the lungs after maximum exhalation. And it can be calculated by adding the expiratory reserve volume to the residual volume. Tidal capacity, which is the total volume of air that can be forcefully exhaled after a maximal inhalation. This capacity gives insight into the overall health and function of the respiratory muscles. And vital capacity can be calculated by adding the tidal volume to the inspiratory reserve volume and the expiratory reserve volume. Total lung capacity, which is the total volume of the lungs when fully expanded. And it is the sum of all lung volumes. And it can be calculated by adding the tidal volume, inspiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume, and the residual volume. It can also be calculated by adding the vital capacity to the residual volume. But as previously mentioned, lung volumes and capacities are fundamental concepts in respiratory physiology, offering deep insights into the function and potential of the human lungs. While volumes provide discrete measures during different phases of respiration, capacities represent combined functional segments. Both are instrumental in diagnosing, understanding, and optimizing our respiratory system. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.